Now, about first chapter, that is heat and formation of heat, what are the topics in heat, evaporation and so on. We have discussed in the first chapter, that is heat. Now let us move on to the next chapter, that is in 10th class we have the next chapter in physics part, refraction of light at plane surfaces. What is that? Refraction of light at plane surfaces. Refraction of light at plane surfaces. Before we go to this chapter, let us find out what is light. Light is a form of energy. What is light? Light is a form of energy. Unless and until there is light, you cannot see any object in front of you. Or unless the light is focused on the object, we cannot see the objects which are in front of you also. It's a very essential of light, and the properties of light we call it as optics. The study of light and its properties is called optics. What is optics? The study of light and its properties is called light. Now just now I told you what is light. Light is nothing but it is a form of energy. What? Light is a form of energy. And we also know that light travels in straight line.
What is
light? Is a form of energy, and light travels only in straight line. In our earlier classes, like in 7th class and 6th class, we have observed that light travels only in straight line. We have experiment to show that light travels in straight line. Do you remember that? Did you remember that? See,
when I
place a candle, and I have taken two cardboards. Two or three cardboards. And make a hole at the center for all the three.
Make
at the center of all the three cardboards.
Now
it this experiment in a dark room. Place this candle. Candle is nothing but source of light. From candle, what are you going to get? Light. Candle, bulb, these are the sources of light. Source means which give. Source means which give. So, candle is the source of light. So, when I am performing this experiment in a dark room, the light from the candle moves. The light from the candle moves through the hole. You can observe that when the three holes are in a straight line, then we can say that the light is traveling through all these holes. If you disturb one of the cardboard, there is no hole to pass through. So that's why the light does not pass through. we can say that only the light travels only in straight line.
By the principle, what do you understand?
Light travels in straight line. So what is light? Light is a form of energy. So children, once again say, what is light? Light is a form of energy and it travels in straight line only. If there is no straight line, if there is no passage of straight line for the light, it does not pass through. It stops the light. It does not carry, the light is not carried away. It just stops the light. So light is carried only when there is a straight path. If the straight path is having any obstacles, then the light is stopped then and there itself. The light does not pass through. What is light? A form of energy, and light travels only in straight line. Next. When do you form a shadow? Did you observe when you are going in the sunlight? When you are going in the sunlight, you observe that a shadow is formed towards the other side, opposite to the sun. Did you observe ever a shadow? These shadows are formed when there is the presence of light.
Shadow
formed when there is presence of light. So, how a shadow is formed? When do you observe this shadow? When any obstacle blocks the light, then you will get a shadow. So when do you get a shadow? When any obstacle is obstructing the light to pass through, then there is a formation of shadows. You might have observed your shadow when you are walking in the sunlight. Your shadow will be longer in the morning
and
your shadow will be
long
in the evening. When they are in the mornings and evenings, the shadows are longer in the morning and longer in the evening, and they are shorter in afternoon. Why they are shorter in afternoon? Why they are longer in the mornings and evenings? It's only because the sun rays are slant in the mornings and evenings. In the evening, the sun rays are slant. So that's why we are getting a longer shadow in morning and as well as in the evening. And in the afternoon session, the sun is over our head. The sun is over our head. So the distance is short. So that's why we get a, the sun rays are straight. So that's why we get shorter shadows in afternoon. Shadow formation. Next one.
Did you
the mirror?
Mirror.
To get up early in the morning, we look into the mirror. Why do you look into the mirror? We are all human beings. We want to know how beautiful we are. For that purpose, you are looking into the mirror. Especially the girls, they want to look beautiful. So that's why they look into the mirror. And they improve their glamour. They want to be look beautiful. They want to attract others' attention towards themselves.
They want
beautiful. So that's why they are going in, they are always seeing into the mirror. So what is a mirror? A mirror is a surface. Let us see, what is mirror? Did you observe? And it is a plain mirror. What you have in your houses?
No.
Is there without a mirror? In all of our houses, we have mirrors. Did you ever observe a mirror? At the back side of the mirror, it is coated with a brown paint. Did you observe the mirror? If you have not observed, try to observe the mirror. At the back side of a mirror, there is a brown coated or a silver coated. Till now, if you have not observed this, please observe this. Take a mirror and see the back side. Observe the back side of the mirror. When you observe this, you see that a paint or a coat is a part at the back side of the mirror. So what is mirror? It is nothing but it is a glass piece. It is a glass plate which is coated at the back side. One side it is coated. One coated. If it is coated back side, the front side is as such reflecting surface.
Fine.
This you have observed. This is a mirror. This is the reflecting surface. And back side it is coated. When it is coated, whatever the light falling on the mirror, as it is coated at the back side, it is reflected back. So that's why when you are looking into the mirror, you get your own image. This is called mirror. So what is a mirror? A mirror is nothing but simply a glass piece. What is a mirror? A mirror is simply a glass piece which is coated at one side. It is coated at one side. When you coat at the other side, whatever the light is fallen on this, it will be reflected. Whatever this light is fallen on this surface, it will be reflected. So, what is a mirror? A mirror is simply a glass plate. A mirror is simply a glass plate
which is coated one side.
That means painted at one side so that the other part acts as a reflecting surface. So here just now I told you this is a reflecting surface. And this is a non-reflecting surface. So, did you observe what is reflecting surface and what is non-reflecting surface? The light which is fallen on the mirror, if you are getting the reflection back, then it is reflecting surface. You have observed it. You cannot, the light, even though the light is falling on the mirror, on this object, it is not reflected. So here the ray is not reflected. So that's why it is non-reflecting surface. So in mirror you have reflecting, this is reflecting surface, and the back side which is coated. Reflecting surface.
This is
face non-reflecting surface. What is mirror? It is simply a glass plate which is coated at one side, and in this mirror, as it is coated at the other side, one surface acts as reflecting surface and the back side of it acts as non-reflecting surface. Now let us go for the next part. Two types.
Mirror.
How many types of mirrors we have? We have two types of mirrors. One is plane mirror, and other one is mirror.
Children.
Of mirror. Mirrors are there. What are they? There are two types of mirrors. One is plane mirror and the other one is spherical mirror. What is a mirror? Mirror is simply a glass plate which is coated at the back. Now, just now I have said what is mirror. How many types of mirror we have? We have two types of mirrors. One is plane mirrors and the other one is spherical mirrors. Now let us see what are plane mirrors. The mirrors which are in a shape, the mirrors which have a plane surface are called plane mirrors. The mirrors which have plane surface are called plane mirrors. The mirrors which are in spherical surface are in the form of sphere. Sphere means a round ball. So the mirrors which are in the shape of a sphere or a round shape are called spherical mirrors. So what are plane mirrors and what are spherical mirrors? What are plane mirrors and what are spherical mirrors? The surfaces which are plane are called plane mirrors. The surface here, if the surface of the mirrors are in sphere or a round shape, then they are called as spherical mirrors. Now let us see what is mirror formula. Mirror formula. Operation of a mirror formula. Till now we have seen what is mirror, how many types of mirrors we have, and what are they. What is mirror? Mirror is a glass plate coated at one end. There are two types of mirrors. One is spherical mirror and the other one is plane mirror. The mirrors which are in the plane surface are called as plane mirrors. The mirrors which are in the form of sphere are called spherical mirror. Now let us see mirror formula. Formula 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. What is mirror formula? Children say what is mirror formula? Children please say what is mirror formula? 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. You may ask what is F, what is U and what is V. Formula 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V, where F is the focal length. Focal length of the object. F is the focal length. U is the object distance.
U
distance. V Mirror formula is nothing but 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. Children, what is mirror formula? 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V, where F is the focal length of the object, or F is the focal length, U is the object distance, and V is the image distance. You may ask, what is object distance and what is image distance? The distance between, for example, when I am looking into the mirror, when I am looking into the mirror, I am the object. I am the object. And whatever I am getting in the mirror, that is the image. So, as I am the object, the distance between the object and the mirror is called object distance. The object and the mirror is called object distance. The distance between the image and the mirror is called image distance. What is object distance and image distance? Object distance means the distance between the object and the mirror is called object distance. The distance between the mirror and the image is called image distance. Now, about the mirror.
Observe.
What is mirror? How many types of mirror we have? And equation for a mirror formula. Now, let us go in depth. For example, you take a mirror. What is this? A plane mirror.
What is
plane mirror? This is called a plane mirror. Where you see your face daily in your houses. Whatever you have in your houses. They are nothing but plane mirror. You take that mirror. So, this is Place the mirror in such a way that before, just now I told you, this is a reflecting surface and this is coated. This is reflecting surface. Place the reflecting surface like this.
When
mirror, you see your own face. When you look into the mirror, you see your own face. So, this is reflecting surface. And this is the back side. So, this is surface. So, place the mirror like this. This is reflecting surface and this side is non-reflecting surface. Why it is called non-reflecting surface? Because this is coated at the back. So, when you look this side, you can see your own image. When you turn this side and see the mirror, can you look the image? Can you look into the mirror and get the image? No. Your image cannot be seen in the mirror. That means this is non-reflecting surface. Children, did you understand? When you look into the non-reflecting surface, you cannot see your own image. When you look into the reflecting surface only, we can see our image. So, did you understand? This is reflecting surface. This is non-reflecting surface. place this mirror so that the reflecting surface is upwards and the non-reflecting surface is downwards. Now, try to incident one light. Try to put one ray. Try to put one ray or let the ray passes. Try to incident one light ray. When you incident a light ray, it gets reflected. See, this incident ray, I am making it to fall on a mirror. When it falls on a mirror, as it is reflecting surface, it does not pass through. It will be sent back. This is called reflected. This is called reflected ray. What is this? This is called incident ray. What is incident ray? What is this called? Reflected ray. The ray which is incidented on the surface is called incident ray. When it has fallen on a reflecting surface, it just gets back. It just bounces back. That bounced back, the bounced ray is called reflected ray. Now, then what is incident ray and what is reflected ray? The ray which is fallen on the mirror is called incident ray. The ray which is coming out from the mirror is called reflected ray. So what is incident ray? The ray which is incident on a plane surface or a reflecting surface is called incident ray. And it has reflected from the reflecting surface is called reflected ray. So this is incident ray and this is reflected ray. Try to draw one straight line like this. Know that we are making it into two halves. This is called as normal. What is this called? Normal. This is a line which is making into two halves. This is called. Did you understand? Or shall I explain once again? This is non-reflecting surface.
This is
surface. And this is non-reflecting surface. And this is non-reflecting surface. Try to incident one light. This is called incident ray. It is falling towards down. So that's why the arrow is towards down. Did you observe the arrow? It is towards down. So this is incident ray. And whenever a ray is fallen on the reflecting surface, it will be reflected back. It is. This is called incident ray. This is called a reflected ray. When you try to draw one line, normal. What is this? Incident ray. Ray. What is this? Ray. Carefully. This is incident ray. This is reflected ray. And this is normal. Normal means the perpendicular, the line which is drawn between both of them. So that it makes into two halves. So this is called as normal.
This is incident.
This is a reflected ray and this is normal. When I have drawn a line, here there is an angle formed. This is called angle of incidence. And here there is an angle, another angle formed, that is angle of reflection. This. Of reflection. This is angle of incidence, and this angle is called angle of incidence, and this angle is called angle of, I'm sharing this region so that it is easily understood by you. This is called angle of incidence, and this angle made here is called angle of reflection. Protractor. When we take a protractor and measure this angle, that is angle of incidence, and measure the other angle, that is angle of reflection, we observe that if the angle of incidence is 30 degrees, the angle of reflection is also 30 degrees. If the angle of incidence is 45 degrees, the angle of reflection is also 45 degrees. If the angle of incidence is 60 degrees, the angle of reflection is also equal to 60 degrees. By this, what you observe, if the angle of incidence is, just now I told you, 30 degrees, angle of reflection is also 30 degrees. If the incidence is 45 degrees, then 45 degrees, angle of reflection is also equal to 45 degrees. If the angle of incidence is 60 degrees, then the angle of reflection is also equal to 60 degrees. But observe, if the angle of incidence is 30 degrees, angle of reflection is also equal to 30 degrees. That means angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So that means here in this case angle I is equal to angle R. Can I write angle I is equal to angle R? If angle I is 30, angle R is also equal to 30, then I can write angle I is equal to angle R. Angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Here, angle I is 45, that means angle of incidence is 45 degrees, angle of reflection is also equal to 45 degrees, then in this case, can I write angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection? Yes, I can write. If angle of incidence is 60 degrees and angle of reflection is 60 degrees, then both are same. So, by this I can write angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. That means angle I is equal to angle R. When you move other angles, in all the cases, we get that angle I is equal to angle R. That means angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So, do you understand that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection? This is angle of incidence and this is angle of reflection. Now, let me define what is angle of incidence. Now, let me define what is angle of incidence. Of incidence. The angle made by the, see here from the picture, it is easy from the picture. What is this incident ray? What is this normal? What is this? This is incident ray. And what is this? This is normal. Here there is an angle made. So the angle made, this is the angle made. The angle made by the incident ray and the normal, this angle is called angle of incidence. Is it easy, children? Very easy. To the picture, if you understand the picture, it is very easy. Incident ray. This is normal. And here there is some angle. Did you observe there is some angle? So, the angle made by the incident ray and the normal. Once again. The angle made by the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. Children, did you observe? Did you understand? What is angle of incidence? The angle made by the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. So please note it down. The angle made by the incident ray and the normal, the angle made by the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. Is called angle of incidence. What is angle of incidence, children? The angle made by the incident ray and the normal is called angle of incidence. If you get angle of incidence, angle of reflection is same. Or you can easily define angle of reflection. The angle made by the, till now we have seen this part. For this part. Now what is this? There is another part. This, the second part. What is this? What is here? It is making some angle. What is this? This is the angle made by the normal and the reflected ray. Or for your better understanding, you can write the angle made by the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. What is angle of reflection? The angle made by the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. This is angle of incidence and this is angle of reflection. It's very easy, children. This is incidence and this is angle of reflection. The angle made by the reflected ray. What is this ray? Reflected ray. The angle made by the reflected ray and normal is called angle of reflection. Is it clear? Incidence. The angle made by the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. The angle made by the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. What is angle of incidence and what is angle of reflection? The angle made by the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. In the same manner, angle of reflection. In the same manner, angle of reflection. Same definition. The angle made by the, this is same, common. The angle made, the angle made by the, here is instead of incident ray, as this is angle of incidence, we have written incident ray. But here it is angle of reflection, we write the angle made by the reflected ray and normal. Is called angle of reflection. Is called angle of reflection. Children, if you want, you can note down this picture and as well as the definition. The definition is common if you observe only a simple difference. Here it is incident ray, here it is reflected ray. The angle made by the incident ray and normal is called angle of incidence. The angle made by the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. So children, did you understand? This is all about angle of incidence, and angle of
reflection.
Incident ray,
reflected ray.
Incident ray means which is fallen on the mirror. Reflected ray means which is coming out from the mirror. Next. Discussed about the plane mirror. Now let us see spherical mirror. This is of sphere. That's why we call it as a spherical mirror. So take one mirror like this and try to draw a line. The center of the mirror. The center of the mirror is called pole, or you can call it as vertex, or you can call it as geometric center. Geometric center. This is called, the center of the mirror is called pole, or it can be called as vertex, or it can be called as geometric center. Did you understand? The center of the spherical mirror is called pole or vertex or geometric center. What is this point called? For example, if I given a spherical mirror, this is the center. This center of the mirror, what is this called? Pole, or it can be called as vertex, or it can call as geometric center. Did you understand? The center of the spherical mirror is called pole, or it can be called as vertex, or it can be called as geometric center. It is very simple, children. You can easily understand it. Geometric center, and this is one ray. The ray which is passing through the center is called principal axis. This is called principal axis. The ray, what is principal axis? The ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. What is principal axis? The ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. This is called principal axis. Now, I will draw two rays. This is one ray which is incidented on a mirror, as it is, this is reflecting surface, and this side it is non-reflecting surface. This is non-reflecting surface. When I have placed one ray, when it is incidented one ray, note it by arrow mark. The arrow mark is this side, means the ray is coming from each direction and it is falling on the mirror. If it falls on a mirror as it is reflecting surface, it will be reflected. The ray is reflected. So, by this we can say that it is incident ray. It is reflected ray. Why? Because it is incidented on the reflecting surface. So, it is incident ray. It is reflected from the surface. So, that's why it is reflected ray. Now, on the above portion of the principal axis, I have drawn one line. And on the below portion, I will incident one light. Whenever it is incidented, it is reflected back like this. So, both the rays are meeting at one point. Did you observe, children? This point which is meeting, are incident rays are meeting or reflected rays are meeting? This is incident ray and this is reflected. This is reflected ray. This is reflected ray of first one. This is reflected ray 1. This is ray number 1. And consider this as ray 1, ray number 1. This is ray number 2. Ray number 1 and ray number 2. This is incident ray number 1 and as it is incident, it has reflected. This is reflected ray of 1. And see number ray 2, second ray. Okay now, ray 2, ray number 2, that means second ray. Whenever it is incidented on this, it has to pass through like this. This is reflected ray. This is reflected ray of second one. This is reflected ray of first one. This is reflected ray of second one. The dark line. You can observe. Now you can easily understand. The dark rays are second ray. Both the rays are meeting at a point. Both the reflected rays are meeting at a point. This point is called focus. What is this point called? What is focus? All the reflected rays, meet at a point is called focus. Now how to define focus? Define focus. If I ask you to define focus, what is the answer from you? Rays meet at a point, or where the reflected rays meet, that point is called focus. Now, did you understand about focus? Where the reflected rays meet is called focus. Next. Pole. I already told you. This is vertex or pole. The distance between the vertex and the focus, this is called focal length of the object. What is focal length of the object? The distance between the vertex and the focus is called focal length of the object. The distance between the focus and the focal length, the distance between the focus and the vertex is called focal length of the object. So, how to define focal length? Distance between pole and focus. Distance between pole and focus is called focal length. So this is pole, or we can call it as vertex. This is pole and we can call it as vertex also. So distance means this distance. The distance between pole or vertex and focus. The distance between pole and focus is called focal length. The distance between pole and focus. This is pole. This is pole. This is focus. This distance is called focal length. If you want, you can note down the picture also. Next. Now till now what we have seen, just to recall it once, we have seen reflection. What is reflection? I have already told you. What is reflection? When the ray is incidented on the surface, it will be reflected back. The bouncing back of light is called reflection. What is reflection? The bouncing back of light is called reflection. What is reflection? The bouncing back of light. Let me write. Bouncing back of light is called reflection. The bouncing back of light is called reflection. What is reflection? The bouncing back of light is called reflection. What is incident ray? Yes, now. What is incident ray? The ray which is incident on a reflecting surface is called incident ray. Next, reflected ray. What is reflected ray? The ray which is reflected from the surface, from the reflecting surface. The ray which is reflected from the reflecting surface is called reflected ray. And I already told you, mirrors are of two types. One is plane mirror and the other one is spherical mirror. What are mirrors? What is a mirror? And how many types of mirrors we have? What is a mirror? Mirror is nothing but simply a glass plate. What is mirror? Mirror is nothing but simply a glass plate coated at the back side. Coated with any color or coated with any paint at the back side. Whether it is brown or silver color. Usually what we are having in our houses, they are painted brown color. So, mirrors are two types. One is plane mirror and spherical mirror. The mirrors which are having plane surfaces are called plane mirrors. And the mirrors which are in a spherical or sphere shape are called spherical mirrors. Next, ray diagram. Ray diagrams are nothing but, just now I have shown you, this is a mirror, concave mirror, and this is my principal axis, and the ray is falling on incident ray, it is reflected like this. When the ray is coming and it is reflected like this, all the reflected rays meet at a point. So, this is called ray diagram. The rays which are shown on a paper are called ray diagrams. Next, I already told you, angle I means angle of incidence, angle of reflection and normal. Angle of incidence means the angle made by the incident ray and the normal are called or is called angle of incidence. Angle of reflection. Next one is angle of reflection. The angle made by the reflected ray and the normal is called angle of reflection. Next, plane of reflection. Plane of reflection means when I have drawn the picture, this is reflecting surface and this is non-reflecting surface. What is this surface called? Reflecting surface. What is this surface called? Non-reflecting surface. And this is an incident ray. And this is a reflected ray. And this is the normal. This is reflection. This is reflection. Reflection part, and this is non-reflecting surface. This is reflecting surface and this is non-reflecting surface. This is incident ray. What is this called? Incident ray. This is normal and this is reflected ray. Did you observe here one thing? The incident ray. This is the normal and this is the reflected ray. All are lying only in the reflecting surface. Nothing is lying in the non-reflecting surface. So, the incident ray and normal and the reflected ray lie in a same plane. That is called plane of reflection. What is this called? Plane of reflection. Now, how do you define plane of reflection? The incident ray, the normal, the reflected ray lie in one plane or lie in a same plane. When all the three are lying in the same plane, that is reflecting surface, then it is called as plane of reflection. What is plane of reflection? The incident ray, the normal, the reflected ray lying in a same plane. Then it is called as plane of reflection. Next one, principal axis. The ray which is passing through the vertex or pole, the ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. Next, paraxial rays and marginal rays. What are paraxial rays and what are marginal rays? This is a spherical mirror. And principal axis. This is principal axis. Just now I told you what is principal axis. The ray. This is the center of the mirror. If I draw a mirror and if I draw a ray like this, is this a principal axis? Children, is this a principal axis? No. Can you say why? This is not a principal axis. What is principal axis? The ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. Is it passing through the center of the mirror? Is it passing through the center of the mirror? No. It is passing through the edge. It is not passing through the center of the mirror. What is center here? The middle part is called as center. The ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. Why? Because this is the center of the mirror. This is the center of the mirror. The ray which is passing through the center of the mirror is called principal axis. If I draw 2-3 rays, I have drawn 3 rays. This is ray number 1, ray 2, ray number 2, ray number 3. This is ray number 1, ray number 2 and ray number 3. And I have drawn another two rays here. That is ray 4 and ray 5. Ray 1, ray 2, ray 3. All the three rays are near to the principal axis. Near to the principal axis are called paraxial rays. Here, ray number 4 and ray number 5 are far from the principal axis. The rays which are far away from the principal axis are called marginal rays. The rays which are nearby the principal axis are called paraxial rays. The rays which are far away from the principal axis are called paraxial rays.